What does it take to become the best-selling smartphone of the year? That's a question that the new Samsung Galaxy S5 and the Apple iPhone 5S want to try and answer. As ever, the newest iPhone is a thing of beauty. Finely crafted aluminium frame, thin, light at just 112 grams, and rocking its distinctive fingerprint sensing home button. It doesn't look much different from the iPhone 5, but Apple's approach to if it ain't broke hasn't really upset too many fans just yet. The Galaxy S5 certainly doesn't break the mold either, but it does sport a less shiny, more comfortable soft touch back. Make sure that all the important ports are sealed, and the S5 is happy to take a dip in up to 3 feet of water too. Don't try that with your iPhone though, you won't be pleased with the results. Naturally, the S5 is significantly larger in order to accommodate the extra inch of screen. It's still pretty light and plays me too by boasting a fingerprint sensor in its home button as well, but you can't deny that it's a convenient addition. It's a toss-up between the screens on these two phones. They both boast the same resolution and screen tech as their predecessors. A 4-inch Retina LCD on the iPhone and a 5.1-inch Full HD Super AMOLED on the S5. The Galaxy S5 screen certainly has the wow factor with incredibly vivid colours and good contrast. The 5S wins out for its brightness and its size. It may be an inch smaller, but it makes one-handed use that little bit easier as a result. iOS is one of the most popular mobile operating systems on the planet, and with good reason. The interface is clean and simple, eye-catching and super smooth. Samsung's newest TouchWiz interface is a major improvement running atop Android KitKat, but it still can get confusing. There are plenty of options to customize the interface, and the settings menu may be cleaner, but it goes on forever. The S-Health app and its ability to read your heart rate is a cool addition, if a little novel, and the My Magazine feed gives you the news you want to hear about in a Flipboard-style format. In essence, the S5 offers a ton of stuff out of the box, while the iPhone leaves you to pick and choose from the App Store, arguably giving you more control over what takes up the space on your phone from the off. It's tricky to compare the muscle on show here. The Galaxy S5 has one of the most powerful chipsets of any Android device out there right now, the quad-core Snapdragon 801. User experience and heavy-duty apps like 3D games run flawlessly, so this thing will stand you in good stead on your average 2-year contract. Battery life that lasts over a day and a half, even before you reach ultra power saving mode, is awesome too, not to mention it's well connected. The 5S does its own thing. Its A7 dual core chip is the first to support 64-bit architecture, and there's nothing else really like it out there right now. This means that eventually we'll see some pretty powerful apps running on iOS devices, including the 5S. There just aren't really any out there right now to test this theory. You won't get the epic battery life or the breadth of connectivity options that you do with the S5, but you still can manage a day on a single charge. It's not just enough to offer a big sensor now. The 5S and the S5's cameras duke it out on the features department too. Both perform well across the board. You'll appreciate the iPhone's 8-megapixel snapper for its ability to automate everything, making sure exposure and color look as accurate as possible, especially now that it has a dual LED flash. Like the iPhone, the 16-megapixel rear camera on the Galaxy S5 can shoot HDR snaps and slow motion video, but it can also film in 4K, that's 4x HD resolution. The modes have been cut back, which makes it easier to navigate, but there are still a ton of options to choose from. Be prepared to spend a lot of time getting to know the camera's full skill set. If you want a phone built for creating and consuming media, then the Galaxy S5 is an entertainment powerhouse. The iPhone is the reliable alternative. Even if you've never used one, the learning curve is much smaller than that of the S5, and aside from the battery life, it still offers one of the best all-round smartphone experiences there is.